Amen.
Certainly let us govern ourselves accordingly to that, this birthday wish. And I'll tell him, just surprise me, I'm sure. We honor this man and his family.
We stand and receive our pastor.
For us, in all ways and one. On top of everything else, God is still doing a great thing. In the absence of First Lady, our ministries are here, we're blessed to have Brother Matthew back with us on the day. Somewhat, we thought he was visiting until we put in the work. But it's good to see again, as well as he brought the family up from Louisa and many other guests that came up today. We invite you, amen, to go into the Word with us for just for a little while. We're not going to hold you long. But long enough that God will have his way in your life.
Amen.
In our reading from Minister Burns, the 95th Psalms, that's a joyous word for us. I'm talking about, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us shout joyfully, the rock of our salvation. Verses move on, but we're going to go in detail. But just for a thought, amen, this morning, as God moves on the table of our heart, he's the rock of my salvation.
Amen.
Look at somebody real quick and say, rock on.
Rock on.
With every head bowed, every eye closed, Father, we are blessed, better than blessed, because your presence is moving throughout this place. And we thank you for the songs and words and everything that has been said right up to this very point. We're peeping because we know that you are in charge. Touch now, and Father, just deliver unto these your children, your humble servant, Father, that which would have us to speak and say, thank you for these ministries on the pulpit. Bless those who have just lost a loved one. But Father, in the midst of it all, let us have a Holy Ghost time in your name. These and all of the blessings we ask in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. I didn't come to entertain, but I did observe that you were sitting diligently listening to the music. But if the Lord is dealing with you, even in the music, you can move. You can catch your hand.
Amen.
Amen. You can stomp your feet. But you can't do what you don't feel. Right? Let me take that back. So if you feel something during the message, say amen.
Amen.
Our introduction, amen, is coming. David here is a mighty person who God loved very much. But David realized that even in that day and time, people and folk, amen, they had all types of gods. We've heard of the golden calf as Moses came off the mountain. If you look around today, even down for the last 2,000 years, there have been some type of God. Many people have gods. Money to some is a god. A golden calf is an image that we see in more ways than one, not only in the Bible, but somehow or another, animals have become a source of God. We make it a God. One thing I begin to understand is that all of these things that are mounted and molded and put together, they don't have no life in them.
That's right.
But yet we worship them in more ways than one.
My Lord.
There are many examples of Buddha in my travel, in my tenure of military service. I've seen all types of obstacles and folk kneeling before God that they proclaim to be their God. But these gods don't have no eyes. They don't have no ears. They don't have no hands other than the ones that were made by man. But even if they had hands, they can't lift nobody up out of a pit of sin.
That's right.
Somebody help me out there. All of these gods become an excess of things that we idolize, or we assume that it can change the course of our lives.
That's right.
Here in this passage, even as you look into the 96th Psalm, it connects again. We find out that God is a mighty God. Am I right about it?
Yes.
God is a good God.
Yes, yes.
God is an awesome God. And God is God all by himself.
That's right.
He don't need no help from you
That's
and I.
Right. That's right.
He's all that we could ever want and ever hope to be. And above anything else, he is our Alpha Omega, our beginning and the end.
Yes, sir.
But let us look here at the passage. In these verses set before us, the Bible says, O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation.
Yes,
I could ask the question, where or who is your rock? The thought would easily come across, and I would probably get more than one answer. Normally, when somebody does something good, somebody does something spontaneously, we look over to them and say, well, are you rock on now? Or we've even told others that, man, you are really my rock. Meaning that you have meant something, or you have motives. Rock in this sense means motivation. It means lifting up. It means sound. It means foundation.
Yes, sir.
But when God sends these words to the very mouths of this servant, and he identified that let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. The our means this plural. It means he can be your rock and be my rock at the same time. In a world of confusion, misunderstanding, darkness, sinful nature, a lot of things have a tendency to pull us down. And often we get off track. And we're wondering, who is your God? Do I have a witness out there?
Amen.
In the book of Hebrews, on about the 4th and 7th, 4 and 7, the penman actually speaks of these words. It says, the psalm is to appeal to the worship of God in song and praise. And let me be careful when I use the word song and praise here, because there was a time in the churches that songs had meaning. I know some of you ain't going to want to go there.
That's all right.
And there was a concept where you could understand what the person either had gone through, going through, or what God had already done.
Amen.
Somehow in the song, if you had experienced the same thing, it couldn't help but touch you in one way or the other. But in this day and time, we've kind of modernized. You can't modernize the gospel.
That's right.
The gospel is the gospel. But we have solidified and made ourselves comfortable in the sense of entertainment, where Satan is slowly drifting into the congregation.
Come on now.
If the beat is upbeat, if the beat is on time, if the beat has tempo, then the crowd will gather.
Amen.
Help me somebody.
Amen.
But when the beat ain't right, when the beat is down, no thumbs up, the crowd vanishes away.
Amen.
And somehow, words in a song don't express like they used to, because songs were normally written around scripture meaning of a saved soul.
Yes.
Somebody telling somebody about something that they experienced with God. Well, we've got a lot of music in the church now. And when we sing a song, somehow or another, we've drifted into a song just being a song. But when God has done great things in your life, when God has moved mountains out of your way, when God has done all that he could possibly do in any given situation that you have, but he becomes the rock of your salvation. My beginning and the end.
All right.
But let's slow down just a little bit. It's gotten to the point where a song is just a song. Well, I guess they finished. Let it sit down. What's next on the program? Note after the next few lines there, song and praise.
Well.
Praise. We do more at a basketball, football game when it comes to making the Lord. But I'll stop by to tell you, everybody can praise God. Okay, Pastor, I don't understand what you're saying.
Teach us, Pastor.
Then it says, make a joyful noise.
Amen.
See, it's hard to make a joyful noise over top all of that mess that you're trying to cover up.
Amen.
I need somebody to pray about that.
Amen.
Because to make a joyful noise, it helps you to realize what God has brought you through.
That's right. Amen. That's right.
What God has brought you from.
Right.
What he's doing in your life right now.
Yes. Yes.
How he picked you up and turned you around.
Yes.
How he made a way out of nowhere. Yes. How he healed your body. Yes. How he allowed, if you think for Daniel, he can do it for you. Yes. If you think for Moses, he can do it all for you.
Yes.
Anything you ask God to do when he's your rock.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
You don't have to worry about nothing.
Amen.
When it says the praise portion of this is important to the believer. That don't sing a song that you don't have no praise in.
Well, all right.
Help me somebody.
You're right.
Let us stand and sing hymnal number so and so. People are taking their time turning the pages. Yeah, we'll get there. Wow, I ain't never heard this song before. I don't know. I'm not sure about this song. I really don't want to sing it now. Because I don't know it. But to make a joyful noise, you rely on God to even show you the way. If the words are there in front of you, and you got enough, not sense, but if you got enough faith to open your mouth and let the Lord speak through you, the song is going to come out right.
Amen.
And before the first stanza is over, you realize that you're up into that song, giving praise. But in that song, there is so much to understand, so much to feel, so much to know. Because when God is your rock, there is a big difference.
Right.
Yeah. I've got to really let you know that when we become before his presence, we ought to know that I'm not singing because I'm just singing. I'm singing because I'm happy. I'm singing because I'm free.
Right.
I'm singing because I know that I know that I know.
Yes,
I've got something to be thankful for. There ought to be somebody here this morning. There ought to be thankful for God. I've already done, but for what he's doing right now. David had a reason to make the joyful noise. Because it was thankfulness in his heart. We take way too much for granted. I used to mess around out there in the world when I was out there. And that ain't in the message, but just an example. Guys, man, rock on with your bad self. I thought I was something. And somebody. Yes, because somebody say, rock on with your bad self. I'm rocking my way right on to him.
Yeah.
While by somebody who's patting me on the back.
Yes, sir.
Come on, somebody help me out. But there's something different about the God that we serve.
Amen.
This God that we serve, not only is he great, if he could place the moon, the stars,
yes,
the mountains, the sea, if he made you, not only is he great, but he's mighty in the greatness.
Yes.
He's all we could ever want or need.
Yes.
I've got to know beyond any reasonable doubt that I don't have to be down and out for him to be my rock. Because at my lowest time, he's always
yes.
been there with me.
Yes.
Because somebody that knows what I'm talking about. Of my salvation.
Thank you, Lord.
Listen to what God has to say here, even in the third, fourth verse. For the Lord is a great God. Somebody say he's great.
He's great.
You know, we had a saying in the church, God is good. Somebody would say all the time.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
I'm not saying the folk were lying. But everybody went into that.
Yeah.
They just went along with the program. Because when God has been good to you,
yes, sir.
It don't just mellow out of your mouth. It comes out with a shout.
Jesus.
It comes out with a joyful sound.
Right.
It comes out with thankfulness.
Right.
It comes out with expedient joy.
Right.
Can't nobody give you joy like God can.
Right.
Can't nobody make you feel like God can.
Right.
Can't nobody do you like God can. What does it really take for us to have joy, praise, and thankfulness all wrapped into one? Well, the equation equals to the rock of your salvation. And it cannot be the neighbor in the pew beside you. Your rock must be in Jesus. Now, let's define this rock so you just don't get it mixed up with some of these pebbles outside the door. When we say rock of my salvation, he said, upon this rock I will build my church.
Yes, Lord.
Didn't he say that?
Yes.
Now, that's the rock that I want to leave on the table of your heart. Even for the youngest in here, rock not only means rock on with Jesus, rock means that you've got something that nobody else has.
All right.
And let me just make that more clear. The reason I said you have something that nobody else has, because there's only but one of you.
All right.
So your personal relationship, that God being your rock and the portion of your salvation, should mean something. That doesn't make you better than anybody else, but you got a personal relationship that
right.
you can talk to this rock. Anytime you need to talk to him. I don't know how you feel about it, but when he's working with Boomer, he still has to work with me. When he's working with Sister Clark, he still has to work with me. When he's working with my neighbor, my friend, my brothers and my sisters, he still has to work with each one of us. So when you say he's my rock of my salvation, that ought to not only put a boost and assurance that God is not only your God, but he's your Savior.
Yes,
he's
yes, that's right.
The assurance that we need to have is that I don't think I can make it today. Look up and say, he's my rock. I don't believe I can make it through this storm. Look up and say, he's my rock. I don't believe that I'm going to get up out of the sick bed. Look up again and say,
he's my rock.
I don't believe that God can take me any further, but he didn't bring it this far just to leave you behind. He's still your rock. When you're bearing down, he's still your rock. When you have pillow wet with tears.
Yeah,
he's still your rock.
Amen.
I stop by to tell you that not only in a weary land, but he's a shelter in the time of a storm. God is your rock.
Yes, he is.
You got to remember, you don't remember nothing else. You just can't lay this rock down like you do everything else.
All right.
Huh? Because he's standing when you're asleep.
All right.
And while you're in slumber, he's still working on your soul.
Yes.
While you're chilling out, he's trying to pave a way to get you to understand.
Yes, yes.
That the word is the way, the truth, and the life. How can I anchor this in my soul? Just remember one thing. You don't remember nothing else on this day. Darkness is all around.
Yes, yes.
The only way you're going to be able to see is by way of this rock. And your salvation is important to you because you want to get to heaven. He has to be your rock. He is your rock. And when he is your rock, you don't have nothing to worry about. You're just passing through a time zone. And when you get through that time zone, give up this body that you got and put on the new. Because God's got something for you. Not only is it great, but it's eternal.
Yes.
The greatest thing that you would ever have in life is Jesus. Huh?
Amen.
Have I got a witness?
Amen.
The greatest thing that you would have is going to be Jesus. Stand to your feet. Tell somebody your
neighbor.
He's my rock.
He's my rock.
Not only is he my rock.
Not only is he my rock.
But he's the rock of my salvation.
He's the rock of my salvation.
All right, make your way.